Project Management. Chapter 3, Managing Work in Progress. Chapter 3, Contents. Making time for the project, delegating effectively, maintaining momentum, communicating successfully, reviewing progress. Managing project information, monitoring cost, managing changes to scope. Making time for the project. Finding time for longer term work is one of the biggest challenges faced by the managers of smaller projects, especially when the planning stage ends and hands-on work begins. Recognizing your priorities. Get organized. Plan regular 2-hour slots of project time in your diary. Set yourself specific tasks to do in time in 1 week ahead. You need to complete the task successfully. 2. Finding your focus. Start with a plan. Begin every day by spending 5 to 10 minutes getting a handle on your agenda for that day. Delegating effectively. Successful delegation is not easy, especially when you are managing a small project within a multi-project environment. When deciding which tasks and activity to delegate, take time to consider the benefits you would expect. Overcoming barriers to delegation. Get experience, beat indecision, fight guilt, plan well, tackle fear. Number 1. Preparing to delegate. When possible, delegate straight from the plan. As soon as you have identified a task that needs to be done, select someone to do it. Brevity is the essence, and it's not a bad idea to use standard format for this heads-up message. How to compose a heads-up message. Define the scope of the task, set a time frame, ask that delegatee to prepare, set a meeting date. Number 2. Setting the details. Arrange a formal meeting to describe the details of parameters of the task to the delegatee. This will give you a good idea about their level of understanding. Number 3. Holding a split meeting. Organize your delegation meeting 2 parts with a gap to give the delegatee time to reflect before explaining how they will approach their task. Maintaining momentum. Number 1. Motivating yourself. Decide what one thing you will do immediately to progress the task and then do it. Number 2. Beating mental blocks. Don't procrastinate. Avoid putting off challenging tasks every time you do so. You put brake on your motivation for the project as a whole. Number 3. Motivating others. Break the project down into meaningful products that can be completed as on a regular enough basis to maintain sense of progress. Be open about the possibility procrastination as discussed, way to overcome it. Always delegate in the context of the overall project. Find engaging way to represent progress rather than just marking ticks on a list. Communicating successfully. Number 1. Engaging your sponsor and client. Communication with the sponsor should be characterized by a high level of openness and trust from the start of the project. And here is the examples. Number 2. Talking to your team. Maintain an open and honest relationship with your team. Number 3. Choosing the method. Sending a sensitive message by email, for example, means that you run the risk of cause a potentially damaging misunderstanding with the recipient. Reviewing progress. Number 1. Keeping track of progress. An effective review meeting should be one of the part continuous cycle of activity. Number 2. Scheduling review meetings. Keep it brief. Managing project information. Number 1. Assembling your project folder. Set up a project folder or filing system to manage your project documentation as part of the initiation phase of your project. Contents of a project folder. Document schedule, team organizational chart, definition of documents, changes to scope records, project plan and budget, risk log, the minutes of review meetings. Number 2. Organizing the contents. Version control can be helpful because the drafting and signing of processes can be generate multiple versions of individual documents. Monitoring cost. Number 1, managing project accounts. 2, keeping track of cost. 3, cost overrun. And last, adjusting to change. How to monitor invisible cost? Use a timeline system to keep track of time spent. Allocate financial value to time recorded. Base calculation or worker salary breakdown. Add the overhead cost of employing that person. Common reasons for changes to a project scope. 1. A risk goes bad. 2. Loss of resources. 3. New personnel. 4. Poor planning. 5. Indecision. 6. Added benefits. And last, usage change. And that's all. Thank you for listening.